The Philippines has one of the most beautiful laws on solid waste management in the world, if it is properly implemented. This is the Ecological Solid Waste Management Act of 2000, or Republic Act 9003. Mother Earth Foundation was instrumental in changing the title of the law from integrated to ecological. We lobbied the late Senator Raul Rocco, and he made an omnibus amendment to put the word ecological in the title, in the declaration of policies, and in the definition of terms of the law. Mother Earth Foundation defines ecological waste management as the proper way of handling things that we throw away in a manner that does not harm anyone or anything. Humans, animals, plants, and the environment. Republic Act 9003 is a decentralization of solid waste management to the smallest unit of government, the barangay, with the 100% total and full support of the duly elected mayor of the city or municipality. It mandates source segregation, segregated collection, segregated waste destination, and the establishment of a materials recovery facility in every barangay or in a cluster of barangays. We invite you to visit the city of San Fernando, the capital of Pampanga province. This is the first and so far the only city in the Philippines that is compliant to Republic Act 9003 in terms of source segregation, segregated collection, segregated waste destination, and the establishment of a materials recovery facility in every barangay. They have started to put up a materials recovery facility in every subdivision, and they now have 80 materials recovery facilities for the city's 35 barangays. As a matter of fact, Mayor Edwin Santiago and I signed the third memorandum of agreement for the continuation of our collaboration in our partnership in our Road to Zero Waste program. We invite you also to visit our model barangay, Barangay Fort Bonifacio in Taguig City. This is an urban barangay with a population of 20,000 of middle and low income families and a waste diversion rate of 80%. This means 80% of the barangay's waste is diverted from being dumped into a dump site or a landfill. San Fernando City and Barangay Fort Bonifacio prove that for an ecological waste management, local government units do not need expensive, high-tech, and harmful waste disposal facilities like landfills, incinerators, and waste-to-energy. Waste-to-energy facilities use pyrolysis, gasification, plasma arc, and resource-derived fuel. These are all incineration, according to the United States Environmental Protection Agency and the European Union. They destroy much-needed resources and cost hundreds of millions of pesos and even dollars, and are end-of-pipe solutions. We propose that an extended producer responsibility law be legislated in our country and hopefully in all countries. In extended producer responsibility, a producer's responsibility for a product is extended to the post-consumer stage of a product's life cycle and away from municipalities and consumers. Extended producer responsibility policies are also expected to push producers and manufacturers to redesign their products to be environment friendly by putting the responsibility for a product's end of life environmental impacts on the producers. Such change, while reducing waste management costs, should as well reduce materials use and enhance a product's reusability and recyclability. It should be a closed loop system, a cradle to cradle and not a cradle to grave life cycle for all products. With an ecological waste management and an extended producer responsibility, we will truly be on the road to zero waste, a world without waste. We need to mimic nature. Nature does not make waste. We need to conserve finite resources in the only planet we've got, our Mother Earth. Let me end with a quote from Chief Seattle. We did not inherit the earth from our forefathers. We just borrowed it from our children.